Hi everybody, this is Gijs again and I hope you are doing well. This is the last episode of the campfire sessions that is totally dedicated to the Scandinavian Outdoor Award for Fall Winter 21-22. Now, if you tuned into my channel for the very first time, then my name is Gijs. I am a outdoor gear and bike reviewer and I live in the Netherlands. I do my work totally independent, so if you like what I do at the end of this video, then please like this video and also hit the subscribe button. Thanks in advance. Now, the Scandinavian Outdoor Award. If you don't know what that is, then please have a look at the video that I did earlier. I'll put it in the description below and in the link up here. So you have a look at what the Scandinavian Outdoor Award is all about and who my fellow jury members are. Because I'm not the only one, of course. I'm pretty proud to be the president for this year though. Now, in this edition of the campfire session, I will also announce the winner of the EU Vikingøks that I did a while ago, I think about a week ago, and I asked you for comments. I got so many nice comments, so wait till the end of this video till I announce the winner. Now, the subject of this campfire sessions is the SASTA Pesky women's jacket that I'm wearing at the moment, and this is a big advantage of being not too big because I can wear women's clothing quite easily. The SASTA Pesky women's jacket, it's quite a special jacket because it's already available, or it was already available on the market for male, for men, and then it was called the Taiga, but because of some issues with a other brand name holder, Taiga, the name was changed into Pesky, and the Pesky women is really the new one for basically coming season. Now, what the special thing about this jacket is the fact that it is made out of Ventile. And Ventile is a organic cotton, and organic cotton uses way less water, hardly any pesticides and that kind of stuff. So in that respect, it is way more environmentally friendly. The Ventile jacket in this case, it is a sort of a hard shell jacket, and when manufacturers apply for a Scandinavian Outdoor Award, they have to send in a document that explains everything about the jacket to us before we basically start testing it. And they explained that this jacket, it is a weatherproof jacket. That means it is not 100% waterproof, but it is weatherproof. Now, the nice trick with the Ventile material is that it is a very densely woven fabric. And basically the cotton fibers, they are long fibers. What happens when they get wet, they swell. And in that respect, it is a bit like a swell yarn. And if you're Dutch or maybe Swiss or even German, then you might recall tents that were made of cotton. And that was also a yarn that was a swell yarn. So when the fabric closes because it gets wet, it gets more water resistant. Now, of course, in tents and also in this jacket, there is a coating on the outside to make it water repellent and even more water resistant. And now I'll have to put that one on the fire. So in that respect, it is quite water resistant. Now, I have been testing this in the outdoors. Like now, it's quite beautiful weather again. We've had snow, we've had temperatures at minus 13 degrees. I've been snowshoeing in this one, I've been ice skating in this jacket, and I did some hikes in it. And I must say that because it's maybe not a laminate that makes it breathable and waterproof, but it's just a very densely woven fabric, I've got the feeling that the fabric really breathes very well, so I don't get that sweaty when I'm really active. And also with some showers that I've had, and some were quite heavy, I did not have any problem at all with getting rain into the jacket itself. The nice thing is also that not only the material is quite densely woven, but the seams on this fabric, they are taped. Now, except from the outdoors, I also took this jacket into my little laboratory and I put a water repellency test on it. And that really shows that the outside layer, the DWR coating that's on top of basically the fabric, it's really a nice water repellent coating. The good thing about this water repellent coating is that it is free of PFCs. And PFCs, that is the material that basically damages our ozone layer and in that respect also nature. So it's organic cotton and it is a durable water repellent layer coating without PFCs. And I think that's absolutely top notch. Now, in practice, what I really like about the jacket are basically the features. Yes, of course, for me as a male wearing a ladies version, it is quite tapered in the middle. So that is nice if you've got a female shape and you've got this curvy hips thingy. And if this suits you, it really is a nice jacket to wear. What I notice is that even with the size S that I'm wearing, the weight, by the way, 525.7 grams on my precise scale, I can still wear a base layer, a mid layer, and when I really need to, a fleece underneath this to be more warm. The main zipper, that's quite a special one. And now I will have to close up the jacket, and I don't know what's happening with the microphone, which is underneath here. You will see that the zipper, it goes basically from the middle, diagonal up here. It's a two-way zipper, so that's very handy if you need to go to the loo. You can open it, you don't have to take off the whole jacket, which basically keeps you warm. Not only on the women's version, of course, on the male version, this is also very practical. Now, on the top side, there is the zipper, it's in a very nice zipper garage. What I also do like is that the pulling tab, it is of a sort of a leather, or maybe, no, it is leather. It's big, so even with gloves, you can use it very, very well. Now, there's one really nice feature, and now I will have to explain a little bit about the hood. What I've been trying with this one, of course, is wearing the hood with a beanie and also with my cap, because I like the cap when it's getting rainy, and the cap protects my glasses very well. But let me take it off in this time, and I'll show you how the hood works. And I'll zip it up, and I really hope that this is working with the microphone. Now, the hood, it's got a nice thingy on the back, so you can pull it tight around your head, and it's got two strings, four cords around here, so you can pull basically this part towards the cap, towards the hood itself. Now, what I like about this hood is that the cap, basically this one, it is very well reinforced. It protects my glasses from rain pretty good, and also with sun, it really protects it very, very well. What I also do like is that if you pull this one up, now I can, of course, hardly breathe because it's a very densely woven material. And even when I have goggles over here, it's going to be very, very, well, closed. Now, when I open the zipper, then there is a button here. And they don't match up on this side, not here, but they match up at the opening. So now I still have got an opening here that I can use to breathe if I'm really close up with my hood, which I think is pretty clever. The other thing what I do like is that it is also possible to still drink like this if it's very, very cold outside. And when you're very active, this is also a very nice way of ventilating, but still keeping the head protected from wind and rain or snowstorms, which I think this hood is one of the best that I've ever had on my head. Now, let me open it up to get the microphone going again. Like I said before, let me open this. Let me start with the pockets. It's got two large pockets on the side. Again, leather draw cords. They are very, very wide and deep. The zippers, they don't go all the way down. So if you've got something in your pocket, like for example car keys or a little bit of money, it won't drop out immediately if you move around with the pockets open, so that's good. But now let me open it, then you will see that on the inside, the pocket has got a mesh, so when you're getting heated up, because you're being very active, then this also works as a ventilation opening. What is a little bit of a pity is that the jacket does not have a dedicated pocket on the inside with a zipper for example, a smartphone or a wallet or a passport. That's something that I always like, but hey, if you're wearing a backpack, then maybe it's in your backpack, so you don't have this problem. Now, what is good also, not only that the collar is really high and shelters me very well, but also the cuffs. They are with Velcro. They tie down very, very easily. The outer part, oh, that's a lot of smoke. Are you still seeing me? This is going to be a little bit of a trick. Now, the cuffs, they are also very, very well made, because the outside is a little bit further over the wrist, so that's good for the protection. And on the inside, or basically on the back side, there is this little piece of reflection. So if you're walking down the road at night, then if you walk like this, people will still see you from behind, which I think is absolutely perfect. Now, there are a few things left for me to talk about, and that is basically that it is not made in Scandinavia, but it is made in Estonia, which is still Europe. So in that respect, if you live into Europe, it's still very sustainable. The other thing is that is the price. It is 590 euros, and that sounds like a lot of money, but from my first experience, this jacket will last you a very long time. And what I do especially like about the SASTA brand is that they started in 1969, which is my year of birth, that they started already with a repair service for their clothing and all the things that they do, which I think is also, of course, very sustainable. Yes, it's not for free. They charge you about 40 euros per hour if they need to work on it. And most repairs, they say they do it in 1 hour or underneath this one. So I think that's very good too. Now, this is the Scandinavian Outdoor Award for 21-22. But the good news is that if you want to buy this jacket, yes, it is available already. And I'll put the link to the manufacturer below in the description, so you can have a look where you can buy this jacket if you want it. Now, this is what I wanted to tell you about the SASTA Pesky Women's Jacket. Now, let's head on to the prize winner of the EU Vikingøks. And as I said in the beginning, I'm very grateful to all of your nice comments. I really had a lot, and basically they went into two ways. People who wanted the axe for themselves to chop wood because they didn't have one and they really miss a axe. The other one was that people want to give it as a present to their boyfriend, girlfriend, wife, husband, or some to their kids to practice some axe work. But there was one comment that really was, well, it made me laugh a lot. And now I have to take my iPhone and read it to you because it's that good. I would really like this axe because I could make bad puns with it. If people would ever ask me where I got the axe, then I could tell them exactly that it was an accidental double from YouTube outdoor guy Gijs, thanks to the Brexit delays. Now, you tell me how many times he used the word axe in this sentence. And if you are the one who is watching now and who wrote this, then you know who you are. But this axe goes to, now this one, but the new one, goes to Pau Gau. Congratulations. Please send me your contact details to gijs@outdoorguru.com. And I'll send the axe to you, if possible, because some laws don't allow axes to be sent. But we'll find out how we do this in the end. Now, thank you so much for watching. I really hope you liked this video, and if you did, please give it a like and leave a comment below. Also, if you've got any suggestions, remarks or questions, please use the comment section because that's what it's for, and I'm more than happy to answer everything that you can throw at me. If you want to see more reviews, then please have a look at my playlist of the outdoor gear favorites, of my outdoor gear favorites, and I'll put it in the description below and again in the link up here. And also in the description below, I've got more I've got a playlist on more videos that I did in this series of the Scandinavian Outdoor Award, so have a look at that one as well. Now, if you like what I do, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the alarm bell so you know when I uploaded a new video. And if you do, many thanks in advance, because it really helps me making more videos. If you keep on watching, then please enjoy my videos. And if you're done for today, then enjoy the outdoors and stay safe. Ciao, ciao. Bam. And now I'm going to have a little cup of coffee again. And the dogs of the neighbors, they're going crazy because they don't know what I'm doing. And I'll give you a little secret on how I shoot my videos. I'll take my iPhone and I'll show you just a little bit on what I've got in front of me, because I'm not even sure if this is very practical, but this is what I had to put into my garden. Some foamy board and some reflection wood, because the sun is in my back and it's overpowering everything. So I had to put a lot of stuff there, otherwise I can't shoot this video. Now you know how we do this. Bye bye.